Hi, I'm Erin Silva, Organic and Sustainable Cropping System Specialist with the University of Wisconsin Extension. Today I want to talk about optimizing the cover crop-based no-till system specifically for organic management. The cover crop-based no-till system involves planting a fall cover crop, letting that cover crop overwinter, and then coming in the following spring and terminating that cover crop either with a mower or with a roller crimper. One of the first questions I often get from organic farmers looking to integrate this technique into their system is, how do I fit this into my crop rotation? And here in Wisconsin, in the upper Midwestern region of the US, one of the best solutions is to fit into an alfalfa, corn, cereal grain, and soybean rotation, with the alfalfa established for 2 to 3 years, followed by a corn crop, either for silage or for grain, and then coming in with a cereal grain crop, either winter wheat or oat. And that cereal grain is then harvested in the late summer, which allows for early establishment of the rye cover crop, which ensures adequate biomass for rolling and crimping the following year. And here in Wisconsin, that rye establishment really needs to occur between September 15th and October 15th. Whereas a rye crop for a typical cover crop can be established later in the fall, for this technique, it really is essential that that rye is established early to allow for adequate biomass and adequate weed suppression during the soybean year. Another factor that a farmer would want to consider when adopting this technique are the appropriate equipment modifications to allow for both successful rolling and crimping and successful planting of the soybean. One of the first things that we did here at the University of Wisconsin-Madison was to front mount the roller crimper using a 3-point hitch. By front mounting the roller crimper, it allows for the crimper to make contact with the rye crop before the tractor, which allows for more effective termination. It also allows for more successful seeding on larger acreage, where you don't have to go across the field after crimping, and allows for more precise seeding and more precise row spacing. Other equipment modifications involve the planting equipment. And farmers often ask me, should I plant with a no-till grain drill on narrow row spacing, or should I plant on 30-inch row spacing with a corn planter? And we recommend planting with 30-inch rows with a corn planter, as this allows for farmers to come in and do high residue cultivation later in the season if the rye residue is not adequate to suppress the weeds throughout the entire summer period. Other equipment modifications are valuable as well, and Alex, a field technician here at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, has done several modifications to our equipment to ensure success in the system.
So the first thing I started with on this planter was to put frame-mounted no-till coulters. You can see how they're mounted here and slicing through the first part of the residue. And it's separate from the row unit, and so you get the whole weight of the frame on the planter pushing down. Right here are the double disc openers on the row unit about to cut through the residue. We were able to get 600 pounds of pressure per row unit by adding the AGCO heavy duty down pressure springs. The other modification I'd like to point out is that I added weights to the planter as well. I added about 1200 pounds of weight, and this is a 6-row planter. It's about 200 pounds per row unit. So as you can see, the combination of the heavy duty down pressure springs as well as the additional weight that we put on the planter has allowed the no-till coulter and the double disc openers to slice through this residue, and you can see how it cut right through the plant. The thing you want to make sure of, as with anything, after you spend all that time working on your planter, you want to make sure you have it set properly in the field, that you're getting good soil to seed contact, that you're getting the soybeans through the rye and into the ground.
After 8 years of research in cover crop-based no-till here at the University of Wisconsin-Madison, we've seen great success using this system. By using cover crop-based no-till, organic farmers in Wisconsin can eliminate tillage and cultivation in the soybean phase of their crop rotation. We typically get now about 40 to 45 bushel an acre using this technique. And by adopting the recommendations provided today, organic farmers can optimize success of this technique in their systems. For further information, you can visit my website, uworganic.wisc.edu, where I'll post research updates and further information.